In this video, I will be discussing another mathematical fallacy. How can you prove that 1 is equal to negative 1? Can you spot a mistake? If you can spot the mistake, please leave your comments down below. And here is my proof. From a very beautiful equation of Euler. So this equation of Euler is popularly known as Euler's identity, which is e to the power pi I plus 1 is equal to 0. So this very beautiful equation, if I subtract both sides of the equation by 1, so what will remain at the left, that's e to the power pi I, and at the right side is negative 1. But I can rewrite this like that's the log of negative 1 is equal to pi I. Now, this is the logarithmic form of this one. Now, I will label this one as my first equation. Now, I can rewrite this negative 1 at the right side of the equation as I squared, because we know that I squared is equal to negative 1. And if I raise both sides of the equation by negative 1, so raising negative 1 at the left and at the right, I will also raise this one to negative 1. So what will I get? I will have e to the power negative pi I, because you know, an exponent raised to another exponent, you multiply. So this is negative pi I. And at the right, we get 1 over I squared. Because when the exponent is a negative 1, we get a reciprocal of this. But I can rewrite that 1 over I squared as 1 over I quantity raised to the power of 2. Because you know, the square of 1 is 1, and the square of the denominator I is I squared. So what will I do? I will multiply the term 1 over I by 1. And what term is that? I over I, because I over I is 1, so I just multiply 1 to this term. So what I get is just I over I squared quantity squared. And we know that the I squared is just negative 1. There. And this one, negative, when you divide this one to I, you will get just negative I. So you square that, you will get this equation. But the logarithmic form of this equation is the log of negative I quantity squared is negative pi I. So the log of this is equal to the exponent negative pi I. But I can apply the law of logarithm, so that is 2 times the log of negative I, which is equal to negative pi I. And dividing both sides of the equation by 2, I will get log of negative I is equal to negative pi I over 2. I will label this equation as my equation 2. Since we know that the log of negative I quantity squared, when you apply the law of logarithm, that is equal to 2 times the log of the negative I. Now, instead of writing the log of the negative I, I will substitute there its equivalent from equation 2, and the value of that is negative pi I over 2. So substituting that value to the right side of the equation, I will get 2 times negative pi I over 2. Because this log of the negative I is just equal to this. And I can cancel 2 here. So the log of the negative I quantity squared is equal to the negative pi I. But taking the square of negative I is the same as the log of I squared. And the log of I squared is the same as the log of negative 1. Because the I squared is negative 1. And the log of negative 1 from the first equation, this one, the log of negative 1 is equal to pi I. So the log of negative 1 is pi I. So instead of writing this one, I will write pi I. So pi I to the left, but negative pi I at the right. So dividing both sides of the equation by pi I, pi I at the left, pi I at the right, I will get 1 at the left side, because this one cancels and this one cancels, and that is negative 1. End of the proof. Can you spot the mistake? If you can spot a mistake, please leave your comments down below. If you learned something today, please check out my channel for more videos like this and click subscribe. Click the notification bell below so you'll get notified whenever I'll be posting a new video. Don't forget to like this video to show your support. And always remember to map your way up.